Donnie and Dolly. The team is supported by AbleAuctions.ca. Closing your business? We can help.
Today's guest, including Craig Button, standing by, brought to you by the Bayside Oceanfront Resort. Located oceanside in beautiful Parksville, the Bayside Resort is one of Vancouver Island's premier getaway spots. Looking for a winter getaway? Stay at the Bayside in December or January and get 25% off your nightly room rate by mentioning Donnie and Dolly. Book your island getaway today at BaysideOceanfrontResort.com or call 250-248-8333 as we bring in TSN Scouting Director Craig Button. How are you, sir?
I am good, but the bigger question is how's everybody out in the Lower Mainland after that burst of winter came in and upset everything?
Well, I'll tell you what, we had quite the show yesterday. We didn't make it in, Craig. That'll give you a hit. Yeah, everything's fine. The criticism of Vancouver drivers in the snow has settled down, and everybody seems fine, although we're supposed to get another burst of snow on Friday. So we'll get back to you on that. Hey, Craig, cracking over St. Louis 5-2, of course, the Blues team that beat the Canucks the night before on Monday. Cracking in a playoff spot in their second year, 10 points up on the Canucks. What are they doing well?
Well, a couple of things that they've done really well. They've got more offense this year. You know, Matty Beniers has come in as a rookie and performed really nicely. But it doesn't stop there. Andre Burakovsky is performing well. Jordan Eberle, you know, with less of a burden on him, is having a terrific season. Jaden Schwartz, who was hurt last year. Oliver Bjorkstrand. You know, last year when I watched the Seattle Kraken, you know, they were quick and they were fast. But, you know, they had very little margin for success, and because they didn't have enough offense. And now when your goaltending was as bad as Kraken's goaltending was last year, and it was bad, you know, so now you got a double whammy. You have a tough time scoring and giving yourself a little bit of a cushion, and then you got goaltending that takes you right out of games and doesn't give you any hope. Martin Jones has played really well for the Kraken. You know, when they had some injuries early on to the guys they expected to be starters, and the offense is much, much better. And I think that when you combine those two things, you get a team that can have success. And I think that's what I've seen from Seattle this year, and the difference between last year.
Kraken versus Vancouver Thursday, Craig, weather permitting, of course. Hey, let's go back to last weekend. Should Elias Pettersson be considered Vancouver's only untouchable?
Well, I would put Quinn Hughes in that category as well. And I know Thatcher Demko has not played at the same level that we've seen him play. But he's a number one goaltender, and when you think about his age and you think about the time and the patience that the Vancouver Canucks displayed, you know, with him and where he's found himself, you can't find guys like that. And, you know, you can hope and you can go out there. They have their number one goaltender. And, you know, hopefully he comes back and he finds that level of play that we become accustomed to and that I think he's capable of playing, and he's injury-free. So I have three guys in that category because, you know, I see a lot of teams around the league, Donnie, oh, we'll find a goaltender. Yeah, well, Vancouver has one. Well, why are you going to give up the guy that's a number one? And I think he's bona fide number one goal.
Craig, the World Juniors, teams are starting to play pre-tune-up games. The Swedes are going to play the Americans today. Jonathan Lekkerimäki is going to play for the Swedes today. He's been dealing with some concussion issues. But can you give us a preview? Who are the teams to beat? Your overall view of the World Juniors this year?
I really, you know, Canada, I think, is a team to beat. I mean, you know, they return a number of players from the August gold medal success. Yeah. I look at their team. Their defense is big and mobile and can play the game, you know, forward offensively, defensively. They're territorial and really hard to get by. Then the forward group, I mean, they go 13 deep. They go 13 deep. And it's not going to just rely on one line. They got scoring ability all through their lineup, and they can skate. They got skill. They got power. And I just look at a team that I think has got so many elements to overwhelm opponents. Are they going to overwhelm everybody? No, because there's good teams in here. But I think that Canada right now is a really, really decisive favorite going into this tournament. Now, I know that it's on paper, but I look at the other teams. I think Finland, just because they got a little bit of an older team, and I think that gives them a little bit of an opportunity to be the team that can compete against Canada. USA, the 0-3 group has never been good, and so they're going to rely on young players. It's a 19-year-old tournament. Sweden's in the same boat. They're missing Edmondson, Salomonsson, and Havlat. So when you miss three really good defensemen and you have a young group, I think it becomes really hard for you to compete at this point. I think Sweden is set up perfectly to compete for the gold medal on home ice next year in Gothenburg. And the 0-4 group won the U18, which included Jonathan Lekkerimäki. So I see Finland and Canada as the two teams that will be facing off in the gold medal game. USA and Sweden, I just think they're a little bit too young. And, you know, that's where they find them. But next year at this time, you could be asking me the same question. And I think it'll be hard for me to say that USA and Sweden aren't the favorites going into the 2024 World Junior Tournament.
Craig, one player that has just been unbelievable, Josh Morrissey in Winnipeg, second in the NHL for points for a defenseman. Only Erik Karlsson's got more. Four game winners, leads all D with 32 assists. Did you see this coming from him?
Not at this level. I didn't. I mean, I've watched Josh since he was 10 years old. So, you know, he's always been a real good player in his age group. And, you know, I think that, you know, you looked at Josh and you saw a player that was a really good, solid top pair defenseman. And when I say top pair, that means I didn't see him as a number one. He's a clear-cut number one now. I mean, he carries every significant area of the game. He contributes in every significant area of the game. Rick Bowness went in. And this is the benefit of coaching, to understand what players are capable of. He said to Josh, he said, "Josh, you're a great skater. But too much of the time, from what he's seen, you're using your skating to make up mistakes. We're going to get you a little bit more steady, where you're not pressuring and having to chase around. Positional discipline is what I call it." And now he uses his skating because he's so smart. He reads the play exceptionally well. So now he's using the skating to gain advantages for himself. And I think that that's the benefit that Josh has from having Rick Bowness. And keep in mind, Rick Bowness coached Haskinen. He coached Klingberg. He knows how to coach those top-end defensemen. And I think Josh Morrissey is benefiting from Rick Bowness's guidance in a big way.
How long have you followed hockey, Craig? Any idea?
Probably since the day I was born.
Okay, so
were you asking me for years, Donnie? I'm dumb, but I'm not stupid.
Hey, listen, we're in the same category, buddy. I'm right with you. I asked that because earlier this week, Avs beat the Islanders 1-0 in a shootout. Earlier in that game, Cale Makar waves off a tripping penalty. He said, "Hey, that's not fair. That wasn't a trip on Matt Barzal." So the officials agree with them, wave off the penalty. Have you ever seen that?
Never. I never have. I have no recollection of ever seeing that. And I will say this, though. Can we give the Lady Bing to Cale Makar?
Yeah,
right
no
now?
Kidding.
Based on the one play.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's pretty impressive when it's never happened, right? Like if somebody scores 8 goals in a game, we celebrate it. I mean, I you know, that's the other thing is, I don't think there's a referee on the planet that's going to call an embellishment penalty on him this season.
Yeah, no, that's a good point.
I think he just bought himself a get out of jail free card. For anything like that. But, you know, it's right away he kind of goes, no, 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 like he waves it off. And I think it was reaction. Like it was just his reaction. No, I'm the one that fell. And, you know, and after the game, you know, it was interesting to hear Cale talk about it. He said, maybe I shouldn't have done that. You know, maybe I should take the penalty and everything. He was almost sheepish about doing something honorable. But pretty impressive, and just another thing that we've seen from Cale Makar that's unique and impressive.
Yeah, no. Okay, now I want to see him take it to another level. I want to see it in a Stanley Cup final. Yeah. Then I'll be really impressed. hey, Craig, one more. Rangers have won 7 straight. There is all sorts of talk about Gerard Gallant losing his job. What do you like about the way they're playing right now?
You know, I really think that what happened with the Rangers is, and I know Gerard talked about it. He said, we were playing a game where we were loose. And so it wasn't that they were loose for long stretches of games. They were loose in at different points in the game. And, you know, you got to be dialed into the details. You know, I love football. I watch a lot of football. It's no different than, like, you know what? You can't go offside. You know, whatever the snap count is, you can't go offside. It's the same thing in hockey. You know what? Get to your position. You know, if you don't have a play with the puck, don't try to force a play. And I don't think it was this abundance of problems for the New York Rangers. I think it was these select times when they got themselves in what I would call self-inflicted wounds. Mm-hmm. The thing with Gerard Gallant, and I think the benefit is here, you know, when you're trying to instill it in a team, you're trying to say, here's what you got to do. I think what Gerard did was just remind them and says, here's what we've done when we've had success. Let's get back to it. And I think that the players, you know, obviously, you know, knew what they had done to have success. And now they're applying it. And I believe that the first rule of winning is don't beat yourself. And I think the Rangers have eliminated that part in their game. And, you know, they're having success.
This is it before our holidays, Craig. So thanks for doing this. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. All the best, my friend.
Yeah, happy holidays to you and Rick and everybody involved. It's a great joy of mine, and I feel it's a great gift you give me to be part of your show. So thank you very much, and all the best through the holidays and in the new year.
Thank you.
Right back at you, Craig. Thanks so much. Appreciate it.